Hey everyone. So today's video is going to be on particle. I did a poll on Twitter last week and got an overwhelming response to cover this project. The majority of the reason it was on the poll to begin with is because I just recently covered Syscoin and their major competitors, and I realized that I knew nothing about particle. So I figured between a couple people mentioning it to me and me not knowing anything, it would be a good project to just do some research on. So here we are. As my normal disclaimer, I like to state what I'm holding if I have any of the project or any investment in it, and I do not personally hold any particle. Again, I didn't really know much about the project, so that's probably part of the reason why I didn't. I would like to remind everybody, if you're interested, to go check out my website. I have merch now, which took me quite a while to get figured out, but it's up there. And also, if you want to contribute to my YouTube, because obviously this is all done based on my interest or whatever, but Patreon is a great place to support my YouTube if you so wish to do so, and I will put the links in the description. All right, let's get started. So the goal of Particle is to be a decentralized privacy platform that works with any cryptocurrency. Its main features are that it's offering a private currency, a framework for applications, encrypted messaging, and self-governance. I would also like to mention, though, that a lot of those things are still in development as far as the project goes. Particle is a marketplace built as a decentralized app on top of Bitcoin's code base. Let's move on to the project history. So Particle is an open source project, and it is the successor to the Shadow project. That project was started in 2014. 2017 marked the end of the Shadow project and the creation of Particle. The team stated one of the major reasons that they moved on from the project and created something new was because of the name Shadow Project. Apparently, their partners in Hong Kong and some other PR groups had mentioned that the name Shadow Project had a bit of a negative feel and kind of gave people the idea that maybe it was dishonest. They thought that marketing and mass adoption of the project would be much more difficult as the name would be a barrier. To be clear, Particle is not a rebrand of the Shadow Project or Shadow Cash, which it was eventually renamed to. It is an entirely new and separate project. An argument I saw a lot online was that Rhino, which is Particle's lead developer, left a project called Cine to start the Shadow Project and then left the Shadow Project to start Particle. For clarification purposes, I did a little research, asked around, and apparently Rhino was freelanced out by the Cine project to create their messaging system. And then eventually, when Rhino decided to create his own project, he used the code that he had created for Cine for Shadow Project and used that for the messaging app. But by no means was he working for Cine, he was freelanced out, and then he moved on to creating his own project. Up next is the team. So on the website, there's a lot of people listed. I think it's about 21, but the main people that you can find there are Rhino, which I mentioned before, Jirloff, a guy named Paul, and a guy named Shazzy. Another common complaint or a common grievance that I'll see on Twitter or Reddit is that the entire team of Particle is just basically the Shadow Cash or the Shadow Project team moved over to Particle. I went on Bitcoin Talk and I went on a bunch of other sources to figure out who the team was for Shadow Cash. And right now, as far as I know, from what I could match from the Particle website and the old website for Shadow Cash, that only 6 out of the 21 people for Particle are able to be connected back to Shadow Cash. On to the ICO. So there was no formal ICO for Particle, but there was a voluntary contribution period that started in March of 2017 and it lasted about 4 weeks. During that time period, Shadow Cash holders, or SDC holders, were allowed to exchange that for Particle on a 1-to-1 ratio. There were 1,658 participants, which contributed about 78% of the total SDC in circulation. The only way to obtain Particle when it was created was to participate in the SDC swap. So technically, Particle is an instacoin because the amount of the coins that were generated at the Genesis block. However, it is worth mentioning that those Particle coins or part coins that were created at the Genesis of the network were only given to the SDC holders that participated in the swap and didn't go anywhere else. There was also an option within the swap to add an additional contribution of Bitcoin. And basically what that did was it would give you some bonus Particle coins or bonus part, and then that Bitcoin was contributed to the Particle group or the project itself so that it could be used for funding. Shadow Cash was no longer an active project and it was not being developed. So SDC holders had one of two options. They could contribute to the swap and get a 1-to-1 ratio of part, or they could sell their SDC and move on and be done with the project entirely. This funding strategy was designed by their legal advisory firm, MME. This is actually the same legal advisory firm that worked with the Ethereum Foundation. The team wanted to be sure that Particle would not be considered an illegal security and would comply with all local and US laws. When the blockchain was launched, a wallet address with 996,000 PART was set aside for the Particle Foundation. They plan to use this, ideally, for a second round of funding for the project. I've been talking a little bit about the Particle Foundation, but I haven't really mentioned what it was. So the Particle Foundation is a not-for-profit Swiss organization that was founded in 2017. The foundation and the board were created with a strict mission to help with funding and support of the Particle project. They're there to help strengthen the ecosystem, but by no means do they govern or make any choices for the network. Next up is tech. So Particle uses a proof-of-stake protocol consensus system called the Particle Proof-of-Stake Consensus Protocol. If you don't understand what that means as far as proof-of-stake, you can go to my Crypto 101 videos where I cover consensus protocols. The annual inflation of PART tokens is 5%, but it will be decreased by 1% each year until it eventually levels off at 2% overall, and it will stay there. Particle has a total circulating supply of 8.9 million. 7.5 million of that, which ends up being 85%, are publicly owned. Just under 15% of the total circulating PART are held by the Particle Foundation. They're held in two separate wallets, which they have publicly out in the open, and you can look for yourself. Particle states that it can handle 97 transactions per second, and that their block times are 120 seconds. They also state that the fees will be 0.002 PART per kilobyte. But again, this is kind of speculative because the marketplace isn't up and running yet, so these numbers are more of an estimation. PART is the native currency in the Particle platform. It does have a privacy option, but its default is general transactions just like Bitcoin. PART can be seen as the gas that makes the platform run. For every transaction and for every decentralized application, PART needs to be used to pay for the fees. The platform also requires PART so that users can utilize the privacy protocol. Confidential transactions and ring signatures are two additional privacy features that are on the network. This allows for privacy of the transaction amount being sent and also privacy for the sender. This is a completely decentralized and anonymous marketplace that allows buyers and senders to interact without any information being sent in between and without any third parties involved. Let's go over what the platform offers. Obviously, the Particle Marketplace is the biggest selling point. Users can buy and sell with other users anonymously from anywhere in the world. The marketplace is designed to attract anybody that's looking to be an e-commerce merchant. Basically, it's a decentralized, anonymous eBay or Amazon. Fun fact, the users will earn 100% of the revenue of the items that they list on the marketplace. The market's going to be designed to work with a lot of different cryptocurrencies, whether that be through atomic swaps or through their third-party integrations with Changeling and Shapeshift. Either way, there's going to be a lot of variety. Multi-state privacy. So on the platform, Particle can be sent in three different privacy states. You can send it in public, blind, or non. All of them have different privacy levels, and all of them cost a little bit differently too. Public is similar to a normal transaction that you would see with Bitcoin. The only difference is that Particle is native SegWit enabled. This is the transaction that would be the cheapest, and it's also the default for the marketplace. The next one is blind. So this transaction uses a combination of stealth addresses and confidential transaction privacy protocols. It keeps the transferring amount of the transaction visible to only the participants, or also people that are designated to be allowed to see it, while still being able to validate the integrity of the transaction. The next one is Anon. This one uses stealth addresses as well, but instead it uses the ring signature privacy protocols. It will hide both the transfer amounts and the participant's blockchain identity. Ring signatures are pretty well known within the crypto community. If you've ever heard of Monero, this is their main source of privacy protocol. Next up is cold staking. So cold staking would be considered similar to staking offline coins, allowing you essentially to stake, but reducing the risk of having the coins online. The cold staking aspect of the Particle proof of stake also happens to make it quantum resistant. Another feature is decentralized voting. So this system allows any Particle holder to poll others or to vote on the network. Polls will run for a desired number of blocks, and each staked block is considered a voting ticket. Embedding voting in the Particle platform means that users that don't hold the token can't participate in the voting process, and thus this makes all the decision-making left up to the community. Another feature is that it's self-funded. The Particle Foundation will get 10% of all the staking rewards within the Particle network. I was told that averages out to about 3,240 parts a month, and at Particle's current price, that's about $34,500 a month. This is a self-funding mechanism that allows the Particle Foundation to help promote, market, and support the Particle project. This also ensures self-sustainability. This process becomes more profitable as the price of Particle increases. The next feature is secure messaging. This system is managed by Particle's DSN, or what is a data storage network. It's a decentralized message mixnet, and basically all of the nodes hold copies of all of the messages, but they are encrypted end to end. Another feature that they're going to support is currency agnosticism. Basically, they want to reduce the amount of barriers for someone to enter using their platform and to reduce barriers for online shopping. They're going to do this, like I mentioned before, by allowing just about any cryptocurrency on their platform, whether it be through atomic swaps or be through something like Changely. Next up is MAD Escrow, which stands for Mutually Assured Destruction. Basically, that's just a way for them to incentivize a buyer and a seller not to scam one another during the trade. A cool feature they're going to have is private listings. So basically, this is going to be a listing that can only be accessed by an individual if they have this specific key that's associated with the listing. It will not be possible to find private listings on the public side of the marketplace. And while the public listings can actually be moderated out of the Particle marketplace, the private listings cannot. They're going to have an anti-spam listing fee. We see this with a lot of networks. They have some sort of very minor transactionary cost just to prevent a severe spam attack on the network. So Particle will be doing the same thing on their marketplace. They're going to have some sort of a listing fee just to make sure that someone doesn't spam a whole bunch of listings. The Particle desktop app is currently the Particle's main GUI wallet. And although it doesn't contain all of the attributes that it will have eventually, it's currently in development, but it can be downloaded for Macs, Linux, and Windows. There's also a basic Particle QT wallet that was released on the day that Particle was also released. They have a CLI, which is a command client. It basically offers all the same command functions as the other wallets, but it just doesn't have the graphical design. They also have the Particle CoPay mobile wallet. This is a secure wallet that can be used on the desktop or can be used on mobile. That brings us to present day. So they currently have a very active roadmap. I'll leave all the links in the description as usual, but you can go find that and check it out. It's pretty cool. The last I checked CoinMarketCap, their market cap was at 89 million, and I think that put them at like 103 on the list. Again, I don't like talking about price, but it's important to know where it is. I mentioned that they have the desktop wallet for Macs, Linux, and Windows, so that's nice. As far as notable people go, in December of 2017, the Particle Project welcomed on Charlie Schrem as an advisor for the project. Currently, if you'd like to purchase Particle, there's a couple smaller exchanges, but the biggest one that you're going to find it on is going to be Bittrex. Upcoming to look forward to, they are saying that their alpha of their marketplace will be released in 2 weeks, which basically means that you'll be able to use test parts on the testnet network, and then they think that the beta version should be released sometime at the end of this year. As far as priority goes, currently the team is working on the desktop marketplace, and they said the next priority will be working on a mobile marketplace. They said they're focusing on mobile next and not a web marketplace because they feel that most people now are mobile, and they also feel that most of the unbanked world have access via something on a mobile. So they figure the most useful case and the better way for them to get mass adoption on their project is if they go from the desktop to the mobile wallet. One thing I saw on the roadmap that I'm super excited about, I have no idea when it's coming. I don't have a date or anything, but I saw that they're working on Ledger implementation. If any of you have watched any of my videos, you know how much I love my Ledger Nano S, and I think it is extremely important to have, so I'm super excited to see that as something that they're focusing on. On to the pros. So something I like is the varying degrees of privacy within the marketplace. I think it gives people more the ability to choose what they actually want to do. I was also very impressed when I saw that Charlie Schrem was an advisor and mentor for the project. Another pro that I liked was that I found out that the Particle Foundation publishes their financial reports. It's very transparent. You can go on the foundation website and find it for yourself. I appreciate transparency, so I wanted to point that out. Overall, I like the idea that it's a decentralized marketplace. I certainly think there's a need for it, which is what I said in my Syscoin video too. So I'm looking forward to seeing what their marketplace ends up looking like. On to the cons. So I can honestly say, I think out of any project that I've covered, I got the most controversial feedback immediately after the poll ended. On Twitter and stuff, people were very vocal about their opinions on the project. From what I was able to grasp from the arguments, I guess Shadow Cash had been saying that they were going to create a decentralized marketplace, and they told the community that they had an announcement for them, and the whole community thought that it was going to be the Shadow Cash marketplace, but it ended up being the end of that project and the creation of Particle. So some people were a little bit upset, but from what I've been able to gather is the majority of the community, I mean, statistically, it said 78% of SDC holders participated in the swap. So people saying that they're very unhappy with the changeover to the project could just be an opinion, because 78% is a pretty decent amount of people to participate in the coin swap. I personally think that once Particle finally releases their marketplace, this is gonna put a lot of those controversies to rest. You know, once they have a working product and they're out, that just legitimizes them and they no longer really have to defend themselves. So I can see where the, you know, people on Reddit or Twitter or whoever are upset about the change from Shadowcash to Particle are coming from a little bit. But in the same respect, I mean, you know, success for one crypto is success for all cryptos. There's room in this space for everyone, so we all need to learn to be a little bit friendlier. Their competition is Syscoin, and I just covered them recently. I would say BitPay and OpenBazaar. Obviously, right now they don't have a marketplace, so they're kind of behind a little ways as far as what they have for usability. But once they have their marketplace, I think that they're gonna be much more competitive within the market. On to final thoughts. I'd like to mention that in my research, I found that some of the Shadowcash links that were left on either Particle websites or you know, informative write-ups about why they switched over or whatever, they'd say like, here, use this link, read up on this. The link was broken. And I'm sure that's not intentional. The project was from 2014. It is now 2018. I could see that keeping up on those things could be tiresome and they may feel like it's kind of pointless. But from an outsider looking in, when I started doing research and some of the links from Particle for Shadowcash were broken, it just seemed a little, I don't know, not bad, but it was kind of like, it just didn't seem so great. Something else I'd like to add is, obviously I don't like the idea that it has such a spotty history. Even though the projects are entirely separate and SDC is no longer being worked on and Particle has been very successful, when you look for the creation or information on the inception of Particle, you're going to find information on SDC. That history is always going to come up. So I think it's going to be something that's going to be difficult for them to deal with. But again, once their marketplace comes out, the project gets a little bit older, they've had more success, and they legitimize themselves, I do think a lot of this kind of FUD and this negativity around the project will go away. All in all, I'd like to say that I was pleasantly surprised. You know, out of the gate, with all of the comments on Twitter and Reddit and stuff, I was kind of worried that maybe this was going to be a project that I was going to have to say something very obviously negative about. But I don't have to, because I like the project. I think it's cool. I know that it seems like there's probably a lot of competition in the space. And again, time will tell if they can prove themselves. But I think that, again, one crypto success is everybody's. There's room in this space for everyone. We should allow Particle to have, you know, their time and do their project and work on it just like everybody else. So I wish them the best of luck in that. And I do hope that all of this negativity goes away. Final disclaimer, I am not a financial advisor. Please do your own research. Please do not trade off my advice. Please only invest what you are willing to lose. Crypto is very speculative. Remember that. That about wraps it up for today, everyone. I have no idea how long this video is going to be. I suspect it's probably gonna end up being pretty long. So if you hung out and you stayed all the way to the end, thank you for the support, and I'll see you guys soon.